with your hopping, we're going to focus on distance. So push all the way back to the air track. Obviously don't touch it. Go as far as you can. So basically go from the air track to this line. And if you land on me, I won't tell you what will happen. You'll just get in the car. So from up, Josh. It's like from this side down to this line. Try and hop, I'd say. Let's see if you can get there in six or less. I'm giving you a good hand. That was actually...
Oh.
Swing, not bend and kick, Billy. Can you show us? Yeah, no, that's it. The foot that's on the floor, don't lift up onto those toes. Joe, that's a really good... Good. Step, swing.
Are you okay?
Yeah, the idea for it to be a dynamic stretch is that you actually need to be stretching through the motion. So,
do you know why that happened? Because the actual leg swing was really good.
You don't have to do scoot onto the black mat. Black mat is absolutely up to you. But in the acro section, I want you working valdes, which means you might even need to work some back hand screens first. That was sick.
Sorry, just make sure he doesn't actually touch my skin. Thanks, buddy. Keeping
an eye on the front. Kind of front.
Alright, ready, go. One, two, catch it, slow down. Hook on. Drop down. Elbow. Face right. Take them down. Hold the knife, please. No.
You're trying to snap my finger.
You okay? Why are you doing it in between?
Ah! I still not letting go.
Stop.
There's no way in my...
Let me just tell you, man. Through me.
Thank you.
Not quite. That was like all 540 and nothing else.
That's right, it's hard. Like I just said to Beth, like, to do a proper jackknife is harder than a double twist. Double twist, if you get the kind of idea of it, you can pull it around to get jackknife. Quite. Yep. Yep, and the hip turn is the advantage. It's hard, hard to do a long way.
Come on, buddy. Get out of the car. And take a seat. Thank you. Fine shuffle, facing in. It even makes it even better because it helps you bring it. That was great. You know, it just goes palm down right inside. More surface area. Grabs the collar, around the collarbone area, cool. There's the side, grabs the sleeve, hold the elbow. Then they grab your collar. So then, yep, they grab your collar. Okay, thumb in the sleeve, get your grip, and then from there, your hand goes on top and push their hand down. Now you got what you wanted, cool? All right, from there now, okay? We're gonna move to our left and push our left hand down, push our right hand down. Then we're going to scoot up, kick our right leg in the air. Just to get some, yep, right leg goes up, behind their calf. And as you pull your right leg back, you pull your left hand back and take them down. There we go. Nice. And swap. Right, that's it.
Set up and zipping up the outside. That's it.
Oh, grab yourself. Alright, so probably just turn inside on like that. So when I'm up here, okay, I'm going to scoot up to my right leg, yep. So if I see that, we're in the same lead, okay? I'm going here, here. Even though I trip him, but my kicks are going forward.
So your partner feeds you a leg. Okay,
don't be too about that. Sorry. Okay, so they feed you a leg, move back, and then you leave one out there. There you go. That's it. So now you have to what we call pattern recognize. You recognize when the correct leg to attack is there. Okay?
Like anyone, fighters in jiu-jitsu have tells. They move the other leg back, they move the other leg back, and they keep the other one exposed. Okay? There you go. Oh, you almost had it. Make sure you don't run into anything hard. Oh, there it is. Nice. That would be the next level would be if they find themselves in a precarious position, you can then just sweep them. Oh, sacrifice throw, nice.